arterial and the venous supply, that is the blood supply of the thyroid gland. First of all, the arterial supply. This thyroid gland is mainly supplied by, it is the superior thyroid artery. This is the superior thyroid artery, branch of the external carotid artery. Now, this superior thyroid artery is closely related. We have discussed it into the branches of the external carotid artery. It is closely related with the external laryngeal nerve. This is the vagus, superior laryngeal. This is the internal laryngeal. And this is the external laryngeal nerve. So, away from the gland, this superior thyroid artery is closely related with the external laryngeal nerve. But at the apex of the gland, the artery is superficial, while the nerve, that is the external laryngeal nerve, passes deep because it has to supply the cricothyroid muscles. Means near the gland, both structures are away from each other. So, to ligate the artery, superior thyroid artery, it is best to ligate near the thyroid gland to avoid the injury of this external laryngeal nerve. Now the second artery, it is the inferior thyroid artery. This inferior thyroid artery, it is a branch of the thyrocervical trunk. This is the thyrocervical trunk. And the thyrocervical trunk, we know this is a branch of the first part of the subclavian artery. This inferior thyroid artery hooks, curves and runs towards the base of the inferior, base of the thyroid gland. Now, this inferior thyroid artery is closely related with the recurrent laryngeal nerve. This is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. It is the vagus, from the vagus hooks, and this is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. Now if you see, this recurrent laryngeal nerve is away from this inferior thyroid artery, away from the gland. Means, away from the gland, both structures are very distant to each other. But near the gland, it is the inferior thyroid artery and the recurrent laryngeal nerve is very close to each other. So, to avoid the injury of this recurrent laryngeal nerve, the inferior thyroid artery is ligated away from the gland to prevent the injury of the recurrent laryngeal nerve. So, this is the important relationship. The external laryngeal nerve and the recurrent laryngeal nerve, along with the superior thyroid artery and the inferior thyroid artery. In case of the superior thyroid artery, it is best to ligate close the gland. In case of the inferior thyroid artery, it is best to ligate away from the gland. And this recurrent laryngeal nerve, it is the important nerve of the larynx. It supplies all the muscles of larynx except cricothyroid, that is supplied by the external laryngeal nerve, and this recurrent laryngeal nerve supplies the sensory to the larynx below the vocal cord. So this recurrent laryngeal nerve and the inferior thyroid artery relation is very important. This recurrent laryngeal nerve either may pass superficial to the artery or deep to the artery or through the branches. This inferior thyroid artery divided into 4 to 5 branches at the base of the thyroid gland. So it may passes through these branches of the thyroid artery. Now the next artery, it is the thyroidema. This thyroidema artery is present in the 10% of the individuals. And if it is present, it enters through the lower border of the isthmus. We have learned it in the relation of the lower border of the stomach. It is the inferior thyroid gland and it is the thyroid MRT related with the lower border of the stomach. This thyroid MRT, it is a branch of either directly from the arch of aorta. It emerges from the arch of the aorta. This is the arch of the aorta. Or it may take origin from the brachiocephalic tunnel. So thyroid MRT is present. It may take origin direct branch from the arch of the aorta. Or may take origin from this thyrocervical trunk that divides into the common carotid and the subclavian artery on the right side. And the next branch we supply, these are the accessory branches. Accessory artery that supply the thyroid gland. And these accessory artery are the tracheal and the esophageal branches. Tracheal and esophageal artery that supply the thyroid gland. So, this thyroid gland is supplied by the superior thyroid artery, inferior thyroid artery, if present, supplied by the thyroid artery, and it is the accessory branches, that is the tracheal and the esophageal branches that supply the thyroid gland. Now the venous drainage. Venous drainage of the thyroid gland. Generally, veins follow the artery. But in case of the thyroid gland, all wounds does not follow the artery. It is drained by the three veins. It is the superior thyroid vein. The superior thyroid vein emerges from the apex of the thyroid gland and drains into the internal jugular vein. Then it is the middle thyroid gland. This is the middle thyroid gland. It emerges from the middle of the lateral lobe of the thyroid gland and it also drains into the inferior thyroid vein. Now it is the inferior thyroid vein. It is important that there is no inferior thyroid, there is no middle thyroid artery. It is the superior and the inferior thyroid artery. But here it is the middle thyroid vein also present. This inferior thyroid veins emerge from the lower border of the stomach and it drains into the left brachiocephalic vein. So there are superior, middle and the inferior. Superior thyroid veins, middle thyroid veins and the inferior thyroid veins. Superior and the middle drains into the internal jugular vein. They are the tributaries of the internal jugular vein. While the inferior thyroid veins directly drains into the left brachiocephalic vein. Sometimes a vein, another vein is clear. That vein is known as the Kocher's vein. It is occasionally present. And if it is present, it is present between the middle and the inferior thyroid vein. Between the middle and the inferior. And this Kocher veins ultimately drains into the internal jugular vein. Now the lymphatic drainage of the thyroid gland. The lymphatic drainage is divided into the upper part and the lower part. This upper part of the thyroid gland drains into the prelaryngeal group of the lymph node. This is the prelaryngeal group lymph nodes situated in front of the larynx. From this, the lymphatics ultimately drains into the deep cervical group of the lymph nodes. That is the jugulodigastric group of the lymph nodes situated below the posterior belly of the digestive. Now the lymphatics from the lower part of the thyroid gland drains into the pre-tracheal group of the lymph nodes.
the lymph nodes situated in front of the trachea, that is the pretracheal groove. From the pretracheal grooves, this lymphatic ultimately drains into the jugulo-omohyoid groove of the lymph nodes. Major part goes into the jugulo-omohyoid groove of the lymph nodes. Some parts of the lymphatics from the lower part drains vertically downwards, and it drains into the brachiocephalic group of the lymph nodes that are present around the brachiocephalic vein in the superior mediastinum. So this is about the lymphatic drainage of the thyroid gland.